Today we are going to do something very special. We are going to forge a draw knife. Of course, I am not an experienced blacksmith, so I'll use a rather simple forge and tools. I hope you will enjoy this episode. By the way, if you got tips for beginner blacksmiths like me, write them into the comments. I'd be very happy to read them. Now, we are going to make this draw knife out of tool steel. I drew the dimensions onto the steel plate, which is 2.5 millimeters thick. I am using O1 tool steel because it is very easy to work with and also very forgiving regarding the temperatures you need. So now let's cut the draw knife out using an angle grinder. Remember to always wear safety gear when working with tools like this. This is how the tool should look like after the rough cutting is finished. Do yourself a favor and clean the floor after using the angle grinder. Steel dust is pretty bad for your health, especially when breathed in. Use a file to smooth the rough edges. Now mark the holes with a center punch so that the drill bit doesn't slip. Then drill the holes. You can of course use a wireless drill, but a drill press works best. Now look at that shaving. Beautiful, isn't it? I've experienced that wearing long sleeves and good shoes is extremely important. Hot sparks are just as unpleasant as stepping onto hot coals. When you're playing with fire, always have a fire extinguisher around. Now, here's the setup. I put a link to a video from the channel Swallow Forge in the description. He came up with this forge. Turning on the hairdryer will get the fire to forging temperature. As you can see, the steel starts to glow pretty fast. Now bend the shoulders of the draw knife over. This should take only about 3 to 4 heats. A flat and heavy stone also works as an anvil. The last heat should be used to flat out the draw knife as good as possible. Now heat the blade until it reaches critical temperature. This temperature has been reached and the steel isn't attracted to magnets anymore. Alternatively, you can use salt. If it melts when dropped onto the blade, critical temperature is reached since its melting temperature, which is 801 degrees Celsius, is similar to the critical temperature of O1 tool steel, which is about 750 degrees Celsius. Now quench the blade into water. Vegetable oil would be better, but I didn't have enough of it at this point. When a file skates over the blade without removing material, hardening was successful. At this state, the steel is extremely hard, but also very brittle. To show that, I clamped a little piece of steel into the vise and tapped it lightly with a hammer. To prevent that from happening, put the draw knife into the oven at 210 degrees Celsius for 2 times 1 hour. This relaxes the crystal structure of the steel and removes the extreme brittleness. Now sort the pieces for the hammer. Here I'm using 18mm pine. I put a template for the grips into the description. Carve out the area where the shoulders of the draw knife will be. The slots don't have to look perfect. They won't be visible later. Now sharpen the blade. It's easier to do this now when the handles aren't attached to the shoulders. Clamping a block to the tool rest makes it easy to get a very consistent angle and thus an even bevel. Now that's a nice bevel. I didn't sand the front side because I like the rough forged look of steel, but I sanded the back side of the knife to not get the wood dirty. Now lay the shoulder into the slot and drill the holes through the wood. Now lay the other piece onto it and drill the holes straight through. Then glue the pieces together. You should put pins into the holes to make sure that they still align after gluing. After gluing the handle pieces, remove the pins. Now round off the handles. There are many ways to do this. For example, using a wood chisel. Or maybe a lathe. Or the draw knife. Finally, insert the pins into the holes to secure the handles to the knife. I use brass pins because I think they look pretty good. The draw knife is perfectly suitable to remove bark, but can also do a hand plan's work. I hope you enjoyed this rather special video. Thanks for watching!